So today, and in fact this week, we are learning about how money travels, right? So yesterday, let's quickly revise. What did we study? We studied about receipt and payment. In 1 minute, Bhaiya will explain you, ask you two questions, and we'll start with today's concept. Yes? All right. First, we study where does the money go? Yesterday, Bhaiya had 640 rupees. Bhaiya went to Tejas shop. Took one book from Tejas. Did Tejas give that book for free?
No.
No. Right. So what did Bhaiya give in return?
Money.
And Bhaiya got?
Who?
When Bhaiya gives money, that is called as?
Payment.
Excellent. And here, Tejas is receiving money. What is it called as?
Received.
Received. Now, let's quickly revise the next concept that we studied yesterday. Yes? Is all the money that we receive is received?
No.
Yes, it can be received. Now the question is all the money that you receive yours?
No.
Is that money yours every time?
No.
We saw an example. Suppose, say for example,
I get 15,000 rupees every month.
Yes. In the month of March, my younger brother wants 18,000 rupees. Does Bhaiya have 18,000 rupees?
No.
No. So Bhaiya goes to Umar and says, Umar, I want some money. Right? And Umar gives some money to Bhaiya. Now how much money does Bhaiya want? Bhaiya's brother wants 18,000. Bhaiya has 15,000. How much money does Bhaiya want? Ubed? Loudly.
3,000
more. What did you do with subtraction, addition, multiplication? Subtraction. Everyone is clear with this?
Yes.
Umar, will you give me 3,000? Umar gives me? So what is it called? Receipt or payment?
Receipt.
It is called as?
Receipt.
Receipt. Bhaiya received 3,000 rupees. Now think. Is that money that of Bhaiya?
No.
Is that money mine?
No.
Will I have to give that money back to Umar? Umar, yes or no? Do I have to give that money back to you? He's shy, but in reality, technically, do I need to give money back to Umar, Vishal?
Yes.
Yes. So, that this 3,000 rupees is received, but this is not Bhaiya's money. So, what is it called? What is it called? Pranita. It is called as?
Loan.
You have 2 minutes. Quickly discuss 2 examples of receipt, 2 examples of payment. So if she is taking from you, is that a payment or receipt? Let's quickly hear some examples of receipt and payment which you discussed with your partner. Now, you will tell me your partner's example and not yours. Wants to buy a new dress, right? So will it be a payment or receipt for your partner? Your partner, all right, let's take this example. Now Mansi's partner wants to buy a new dress for her grandmother. I'm buying dress for my grandmother, but instead I need to
give money.
Give money. So is it a receipt? It's a receipt for her
grandmother.
And no, it's a receipt for another person.
Shopkeeper.
Think about this. Yes? Everyone understood?
Yes.
Let's quickly move on to today's objective. Yesterday we studied about receipt and payment. Now we will use. And there's one word attached to receipt and payment. What is that one word attached to receipt and payment?
Loan.
No. While self-learning reading, you must have read that one word.
Liability.
It's okay, we'll come back to that new word today. That's new word that we'll study today. It's okay, yeah? Today we are going to use the concept of receipt and payment that we studied yesterday to learn today's new objective. Right? We need to think this week while our money is traveling. We need to think about this. Does our money travel every day? Does our money travel once in a week? Does our money travel once in a month? or once in a year. So we are going to study this today. Yes? Before we start this, I have an example for you. Right? And I want you to think about this as I say this example. Right? Every day, Bhaiya takes an Ola auto to come to school. Right? And when Bhaiya reaches school, based on meter, Bhaiya gives money to Ola driver. And then the driver might go somewhere else. Every day he is earning rupees, which is very different, right? Is it same every day? No. That auto is of Mr. Das. So Ola driver pays Mr. Das 300 rupees every day. So in Mr. Ola driver's case, money is traveling one, same every day, and second, different every day. Right? Let's again discuss this. Now, if the money is traveling same every day, what is the same amount that is traveling every day? 300 rupees. So every day, suppose I am an Ola driver, every day I am giving how many rupees? 300 rupees. Is it the case that I am receiving same money every day?
No.
So every day I am receiving different money. Right? Mainly there are three types of spending. That is, there are three types in which we pay people. Right? One is called daily. Say daily. Second is called monthly. And third is called annual. Right? Daily. For example, Bhaiya comes to school daily. So Bhaiya has to pay auto driver daily. Next, monthly. For example, I am traveling from a bus, from a PMC bus, and I have a bus pass for this month. So in that case, I will pay only one time and travel from first date till last date. Right? That is called monthly. And then there are some expenses which are annual expenses. Om, these expenses are called annual expenses. For example, your school uniform. Do we buy it daily?
No.
Do we buy it monthly?
No.
We buy it only one time?
Yes.
We pay it one time and then we don't pay for the entire
year.
Hrishikesh, what about your notebooks? Will notebooks come under annual?
No.
Will it come under monthly?
Yes.
Yes. Now, in your groups, first discuss with your partner one example each, new example of daily, monthly, annual. And those who do not understand or those who still don't understand, just raise your hand and Bhaiya will come to you. Right? Get back in your groups and discuss one example each. Understood? So if she is taking from you, is that a payment or receipt?
Receipt.
Receipt for her, but?
Payment.
For?
Me payment.
For you it is payment, right? So think from that perspective also, right? For her it's a receipt. Getting my point? So she is also correct. Right? Yes. Quickly, who will tell me a few examples of daily expense? Where do we spend our money daily?
Milk.
We drink milk every day. It's a daily expense. Tell me a few examples of monthly expense. Some new hands now.
Water bottle.
Water bottle. You buy once in 2-3 months. Nice. Yes.
Notebooks,
new examples. We discussed this. Some new examples. Discussed already. Correct answer, but we discussed already. Tiffin box. Excellent. Next, annual. Which are your annual expenses? Umar. Bag of rice for a year. New answers. Something we discussed already. Yes. Seasons. But what expense do we have in seasons? We are talking about how do we spend our money, right? Seasons, correct answer. But how do we spend money?
Gathering.
How do we spend money? You can say gathering dress, gathering costumes. We buy once in a year, right?
Compost box.
Compost box, once in a year. There are only few students who buy compost box once in a year. I see you buying every month. Right? Everyone understood? Daily, monthly, annual expense?
Yeah.
Yes? In next 2 minutes, we'll quickly jump into our stations. Yes? Am I clear? Take 2 minutes just to settle down. Think silently about daily, monthly, annual expense. If you do not understand any part, discuss with your partner. If you still do not understand, raise your hand. But sit silently for next 2 minutes and revise this concept. This group, are you all ready?
Yes.
Is the space empty? Come back, come back, come back, come back, come back. Walk. Yes, here. You will help Aditya also. He was absent. Here in this, for example, a pencil. Look at the pencil and see if it is a daily, monthly or annual expense. Pass, take one and pass. Take one and pass and I will explain you quickly what I was supposed to do. You need to face this chart. Okay. So in your worksheet, you have 6 events written, right? There are 6 events, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes? For every event, read this question and see what are we supposed to answer. Right? For every question, just write the answer here. Once you are done with this, read this problem statement. And then answer question number 1, 2 and 3. Now in this group, there is one twist. Every worksheet is different. Your and your partner's worksheet might be different. Get started. If you still have doubts, you will ask your friends, partners. This problem is related to designing team and finance team. This week we are making new product designing team. Yes. So designing team has listed out some raw materials, right? And then they gave it to resource management. Resource management gave it to finance. They made a list of raw materials. Then they made a list of raw materials and amount, rupees that we need to buy those materials. This is the final quotation that designing team wants from you, right? From finance team. Now, for example, 1 kg of Fevicol, whatever be the amount, you will write it. For 7 cardboards, cost of 1 cardboard is?
9.90.
So, cost of 7 cardboards will be, what are we supposed to do here? Even if you do addition, you will get the answer. But remember, addition, multiplication is?
Repetitive addition.
Repetitive addition. So instead of repeating your addition every time, we can do?
Multiplication.
Right. Can we have all magic fingers ready? Yes? Alright, let's start. This week, we will be visiting Symbiosis College for their annual event. No, again try to do it correctly. Let's close this. Can I have all eyes on me? Be seated where you are, but just turn towards Bhaiya. All eyes on Bhaiya. Before we break for lunch break, let's discuss 2 questions. Yes, 1. How easy or how difficult was it for you to work with your partners? Was it easy? Did you ask your partner for help? Did your partner help you? Whenever you did not understand, did you ask your partner first and then Bhaiya, or did you ask directly Bhaiya? Before raising hand, think. And then we'll discuss. How easy or difficult it was? Mansi. Who was your partner? Om. Why was it easy? You did it 2-3 times together in the station only. Very nice. Did Om ask you for help?
No.
Did you help Om?
No.
You just discussed together?
Yes.
Very nice. They did some questions 2, 3, 4, 5 times also. Omkar. Omkar. Who was your partner?
Pradnya.
Why was it easy? Both of you discussed. That's very important. All eyes on me. See, Omkar told it was easy. Mansi told it was easy. And both of them had one common answer. What was that? Both the partners? Discussed. All right. All those who felt hard? The reason why you felt hard was because you did not discuss. Next question. That is your today's homework. You have to go back at home today and make 3 questions each. Then Shri, 3 questions each of addition, subtraction and multiplication. Now, the question should be some real life problem that you face at home. Am I clear? Once you are done with lunch break, we'll come back and this time you will
discuss
with your partners. Understood?
Yes.
So let's go for lunch break.